Welcome back to GMA Now. I'm Kate Snow. Have you ever had a mom-tini or a mint julep, probably? Well, these two ladies here with me have written a new book. It's called Cocktail Therapy, Leanne Shear, Tracy Toomey. And it's a really interesting book, interesting concept, because the idea is that you sort of pick your cocktail to suit your mood and what you need at the moment, right? You don't want to just go in and have a beer every time. You want to be strategic in your cocktail choice. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
I love the idea. So start out with, and you're also sort of talking about different cocktails to fit different situations, right?
Definitely.
So the first one up is a sangria.
Yeah, it's a Saint Germain sangria. And actually, Leanne and I, we met behind the bar years ago, and we learned quickly that there's a cocktail for every calamity. So this summer we've been spending in the Hamptons, we discovered this Saint Germain, which is an elder.
What is that? I'm not sure I know what
it's
that is.
It's actually pretty amazing. It's an elderflower liqueur. You
take
can
a smell.
I can smell. I'm not allowed to drink on TV, but I can smell.
But you can smell it's got pear
wow.
and passion fruit and citrus.
Really interesting.
And our whole thing is taking a classic cocktail like sangria and giving it a modern twist.
Okay.
So the crisis for this cocktail is you're in the Hamptons and you have 10 unexpected
house
guests.
You're in the Hamptons. I love it. For our non-New York viewers, you're at a posh beach somewhere.
Poor thing.
Our favorite summer home.
Okay.
Which we love.
And you just so happen to have, what, 10 or 20 people drop
just
by.
Just drop by. Okay. So what's a great, entertaining cocktail?
This could happen to you. It could happen.
It could absolutely happen.
Right. Now, this looks beautiful.
So it's tons of fruit. It has a beautiful presentation. It's strawberries and grapes and raspberries, peaches. And then it's a dry white wine. We're using a Sauvignon Blanc. And then the Saint Germain.
And the Saint Germain is sort of the key ingredient.
It's really what makes it a really special cocktail and not just your average sangria.
Right.
And the great thing is the longer it sits, the better it tastes. So you can make this in advance. And then when you have guests drop by, have it. It doubles as dessert. Because you have all
it's
the
very
fruit
sweet.
And
it's fresh local ingredients. It's great for the summertime too, but leading into fall because you can use all sorts of different ingredients.
So put a lot of ice in the glass because you're not going to want to have a lot of those, I would think. Wow. Yeah, that would be good for a crowd. I can see that.
It is, yeah. Make
it's
a pitcher ahead of time. Like I said, the longer it sits, the better it tastes.
How did this come about? I mean, you just sort of thought, we've got so many recipes and we know what's right for what moment.
Right. We always say that the bartender is everyone's most accessible psychotherapist, the cheapest
so true.
One. So people were always coming up to the bar and telling us what was
belly up, baby.
What their problems were. And so we thought it was kind of fun to come up with a technique for we prescribe the antidote for all of life's crises.
Okay, well, the next one is
yes.
for a very specific moment, so tell me about that.
Well, in the Hamptons, in the summer, we do tend to be on the beach all day long, and you sometimes get a little nasty sunburn. So that's a very typical summer crisis, obviously, that we're all dealing with.
Ooh, I smell the mint.
And what we have is this delicious twist on a classic mojito called the pear mojito. So it's great because, like Tracy's doing right now, she's muddling some mint, squeezing fresh lime, again, all fresh ingredients.
I've noticed, if I can interrupt for a second,
sure.
I've noticed I've been traveling a lot lately, and all over the country, mojitos are really big right now.
Just the rage.
And so this is sort of just, like you said, a twist on
exactly.
a variation. Exactly.
That's what we're all about, is just a more modern, fun, sometimes womanly or girly twist on a classic drink that
so
you
So what is that?
This is pear puree. So it's kind of like we have the traditional ingredients in a mojito are lime, mint, simple syrup, rum. But we're adding a little pear puree. Give it a good shake.
Give it a whirl.
And then serve in a highball glass.
Ah.
And the mint is soothing, so it'll help with that sunburn. The lime is refreshing. The rum never hurt anybody.
So good for the end of a long, hot summer day.
Absolutely.
Or some, you know, needing to kind of cool yourself down.
Exactly.
This one, our third drink, is perfect because we make it with pomegranate juice, and pomegranates are good for your heart. So this is a really good one for when you have the Sunday blues, the end of the weekend, you're going back to the city or you're going back to work.
And we're getting to the end of the summer and Labor Day and all of that. So this might be fitting.
Yeah, and it's perfect because it is.
What is it?
Okay, that's pomegranate juice. Very easy to find. You can make it. You can
is
find,
it really easy to find pomegranate juice?
It actually
juice?
Is. Now
yeah.
these days, it these is days? Literally the trendiest thing to add to cocktails right now. Again, forget the sugary mojito, or excuse me. We just made a mojito. The sugary cosmos.
The cosmos, right.
This is just a really fun twist. And like Tracy said, pomegranates Ooh. Have a lot of antioxidants. So it's actually healthy and good for you. So it's
so
a great twist.
So this is champagne of
this
some sort?
This is champagne. This is actually the Clicquot Rosé, but you could use any sort of brut or...
Well, excuse me.
Our ham tonight. But actually, another great thing is you can put pair the Saint Germain with champagne. Is absolutely delicious. That's a huge.
Oh, just the two of them.
Yeah, it's a huge cocktail trend we've seen in the summer.
Well, I think all about cocktails these days, and we talk about this in cocktail therapy, is being really creative. So like Tracy said, she just threw those two together. But there's a lot of different things you can throw together, and it's about having fun with it. There's no stress when it comes to cocktails.
I feel like when I throw things together, though, they end up tasting awful. I think I need you guys to come by the house. So you've both met a lot of celebrities in the bars that you've worked at. Yeah. Do you have any good stories? What are their favorite drinks?
I was going to say, could we really tell the good
stories? Yeah, can you tell me the good stories?
I don't know. My lawyer might not think so. But actually, one of our favorite celebrities, P. Diddy, he's out and about all the time.
I think he's just Diddy now.
Oh, okay, yeah. I don't know. His name changes so much.
Isn't it P. Diddy now? Who knows? Anybody?
Sean. Let's just call him Sean.
Okay.
I think he'd be cool with that.
It's not Puff Daddy, that I'm sure.
No. He's actually, he's a big champagne drinker. Now I think he's drinking more vodka these days. But he would literally come into some of the different bars we've worked and buy 10, 20, 30 bottles
Magnum.
Of champagne.
Now that's just extravagant.
Exactly.
And he's generous, though. At least he would give them out to his friends and to us.
So just a simple champagne.
Pretty much.
No mixing pomegranate juice. Or
simple magnums of Cristal.
For thousands of dollars, if you call that simple.
Right. But also, I mean, then there are people like Ed Burns who drinks Corona and has one and is a great tipper, great guy, and just sort of a simple beer guy, which is great.
Okay. Molly Sims, I keep wanting to call everyone our friend, but really that's not the truth. We just see her out about drinking, but she likes margaritas, which is a great summertime drink to kind of going into fall, keep the summer feeling
alive. Old school?
Yeah, it's old school.
Classic.
Legit. I'm into that.
Excellent. Well, thanks so much. The book is Cocktail Therapy. Leanne, Tracy, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Interesting stuff. And we'll be right back.